Woke up this morning from the strangest dream. I was in the biggest army the world has ever seen. We were marching as one on the road to the Holy Grail. Started out seeking fortune and glory. It's a short song, but it's one hell of a story. When you spend your lifetime trying to get your hands on the Holy Grail. Well, have you heard about the Great Crusade? We ran into millions and nobody got paid. Yeah, we raised four corners of the globe for the Holy Grail.
I was very happy with how I went this season, no doubt. I was placed in position two, one and two. I played one and two, and great expectations were put upon me, and I won most of my matches. I was very happy with 5-1 and 1.
Well, I reckon I went okay. Oh, what did I do? I won three, lost two. Very disappointed with the two I lost because they were rather bad losses. But contrary to that, the other three that I won were good wins. So, yeah, okay. Not a bad season.
This year's Pennant was most enjoyable. I had a pretty good season, but unfortunately I lost the most important game of the year in the final. But senior Pennant is excellent, and the friendships you make over the time and the spirit it's played in is fantastic. And overall, I enjoyed the year immensely, and the team involvement.
I went okay this year. I was very pleased because just before the season I got a melanoma and I didn't think I'd be able to play at all. And luckily I made a recovery, and good old Jim put me in for a couple of four balls, and then I made the final team. So didn't lose a match. We have the final. So good. Happy night.
It was a good year. We had two very good players come into the side and some enthusiastic older people. And after a slow start, we really got it going and played some very solid golf right through to the final.
Yeah, I guess I was lucky. I was fortunate enough to only lose one for the season.
All right, how did I go this season? I played solidly for six games. I was happy with my form, and that's about it.
Yeah, I think I went okay. 1-3, half one, lost one, but very enjoyable. Felt like it contributed.
Highlight of my season was the match against Latrobe at Heidelberg. Totally memorable for me. I learned so much that day. Five shanks in the first seven holes, six down after seven. I took him to 17. I was very happy about that. A highlight of sorts.
The real highlight of the season was in that same match that Steve just described when we were playing Latrobe. He and I were playing in the same group, and I successfully avoided being hit by any of his shanks. So that was a true highlight for me.
The highlight was at Eastern. We hit off the 10th and we were about three up after nine, and with my opponent Phil Abbott we played the first, and I hit a 5-iron up to a blind green, and we got up there and couldn't see it, and I looked over the back and Phil said, have a look in the hole, and sure enough it was in the hole. And I think that really broke our opponents, and I knew Phil thought we were over the line because he put away his smokes. The low light of the season was at Heidelberg, and I was playing with Fuji. We were on the 15th and we were one down. Our opponents were all over the place. One of them had hit a ball into Mick Gatto's backyard, and we went down to the green. We were all over them like a cheap suit. And we found that we'd hit the wrong ball. So I blamed Fuji, and Fuji blamed his caddy, because all of a sudden we were two down and we're in more trouble than Johnny Depp.
The highlight of the season was beating the guy that beat me in the final on the 18th at the Heritage when I sunk about a 20-foot putt. But there was a lot of good highlights during the year, and I was lucky enough to get a few good putts, and that was the difference.
My highlight for the season was the team spirit and also the organisation of Jim Pip, which I thought was outstanding. Teams on a Friday night, he had the summary of the game out. I think by the next Monday, he had the team selected. So it was outstanding, his organisation.
I was particularly pleased with the fact that at the sharp end of the season, the important game against Easton, where I played with Ross Inwood, and in the final, I probably played my best golf of the season. So when the whips were cracking, I was really pleased with the way I was playing.
The highlight for me was to caddy for good old Steve, who'd caddied for me last year in the final against the same player. It was just the look on that guy's face at the end. We both beat him, and to see him say, "I never want to see either of you guys again," was my highlight this year.
To me, the highlight was the first shot at Yerry Meadows where I played in the first time. I enjoyed the fact that I'd made the team and I was able to be involved.
My highlight of the season is much the same as it's been in the past. I get to play against a lot of guys I know quite well than I used to play against 30, 40 years ago. And I love that part of the competition.
We're going to win the finals probably obviously when we had at least five matches in. I think at that stage we had five and a half. Myself and Steve Valentine had finished, so we're actually viewing some of the other matches finished. And at that stage I was very happy for the team, for the supporters and also the caddies. I'd like to take the opportunity to thank my caddy Phil Abbott, Pancho Deneath during the year, and also my VGA caddies, Brenda Moore and Jeff Knott. Thank you.
When I made the last putt on the 18th, which we myself and Vintosa won the four ball, and then we were able, because we were the second group, we were able to sort of count backwards and see where everybody else was, and then we were just tallying up in our heads exactly where things were, and it was looking good, and that was a very nice moment indeed, very enjoyable.
Well, I was in the first match, so I didn't know we were going to win the Pennant flag. There was bleeding ulcers, we had a fantastic match all day. An outrageous birdie by a guy who bounced off a hill and went onto the green when we both made par, got us behind, and we sank a putt on the last green to square the match. So didn't know at that stage, but followed with great interest at the other matches and a bit of tension in the tummy, and of course it was fantastic to win yet again.
There's a high level of excitement. Cap off a year with a win. It's great for the club and for the team, and for Jimmy Pitt, who's our wonderful manager.
The Pennant final, I was ecstatic that we won, because this year we had a bit of youth in the team in Mark Brasher, Steve Valentine and Rossi Henshaw, and I've never seen a more happier guy than Ross Henshaw. He did a great job over the year, and to have those three guys and see them enjoy the win. Fortunately, I've been involved in a few wins, and I think it was just fantastic and to beat the favourites, but I'm glad we did win because I didn't like losing on the 18th.
Yeah, the win on the final day was fantastic. I felt all the emotions of all the other players. I felt all their intensity. And in those last few holes, as the matches were winding down, the wonderful build-up to the celebration later that night.
I won the Pennant final when I was playing, when I was walking down and playing hole 17, which was just as well because I was, my tee shot was in the trees. How'd I feel? Really terrific, really good for the team, really good for the new players in the team, Mark and Steve, who were in the number one and two slots, and Pixie as well. He and I were playing together, and he and I both struggled all day, but we both got over the line. So I was feeling really good about that, and there was a certain amount of relief about winning, because we were supposed to have won because we were playing Heritage on a course which we knew that they weren't going to be very good on. So there was a bit of relief, and of course there was a bit of celebration afterwards. So it was a great day.
Great to be a part of a good bunch of guys in a winning team, and Kew's been very successful in this particular format, and I hope that they continue to do so.
It was probably one of my most exciting and wonderful sporting experiences. I've had the good fortune of playing a number of winning Pennant teams, but this was very special because I'd made my mind up a few weeks ago that this was going to be my last year, that I was becoming one of the old blokes, all these young 55-year-olds, so this was my last shot. So I really wanted to give it my all. And what made it particularly special was that throughout the season, my caddy was Prue, and as Jim Pitt used to refer to as Team Tozer, and so it was great to be able to share a win in the final and the euphoria of the whole team, the excitement, because we'd gone down 8-1 to Heritage in the season, then to win, beat them so convincingly in the final, the euphoria, the feeling of excitement, and was just a wonderful, wonderful feeling.